the history. After the attack on Ethiopia's sovereignty on behalf of the Italian armed forces in 1935, the League of Nations Assembly responded according to the disposed agreement made by the organization, which by decree the application of economical sanctions to the Italian government. But after the agreements between the governments of England, France, and Italy outside of the League, the same organization had been transformed into an instrument that was to submit Ethiopia to Italian pretensions. We were informed, the Emperor recalls, by our delegates that the decision had been made to call for all state representatives to vote on the proposed recommendation, and we had felt the sensation that all were inclined to betray Ethiopia. On the lifting of the sanctions, Mexico was opposed to all the points within the proposition, and withdrew, removed itself from the reunion. The countries present were called to vote in alphabetical order. 44 of them voted in support of the lifting of sanctions. Ethiopia was opposed, and 4 countries remained abstained from the vote. On June 19, 1954, the Emperor Haile Selassie I realized a visit to Mexico and was interviewed by Mexican leader Lázaro Cárdenas. Facing conflict, not all were traitors, not all were cowards. In the dark hours, when the minutes slipped between the hands with no power to prevent the tragedy, when the palpitating heart sounds within the chest and the seconds expand without giving breath between beat and throb, a voice is raised courageously in defense of the covenant and of the international right, tearing through the criminal cycle of silence faced off against the heartless conspirators and their cowardly accomplices of a passive attitude. International Brotherhood, the Lion of Judah in Mexico. Ethiopia does not forget that Mexico denied recognition of the acts committed by the Italian forces, and that it raised the voice in defense of the reason of truth, of justice, and of right. We employ the word brothers with the most upright exactitude when referring to Mexico and to all Mexicans, since we shall never forget the fraternal and virile attitude that the Mexican delegation developed in defense of the holy rights of Ethiopia. In those moments of our millennial history as a state with more than 30 centuries of sovereign existence and independence, the voice of Mexico was raised one more time, generous and courageous, making itself heard to defend Ethiopia as the vigorous champion. Floating in this atmosphere left by their words, a well-felt expression of a people convinced that there is a God and an imminent justice that cannot permit the continuity of evil, wrong, nor can it reconcile to consolidate acts of injustice. To all light, contrary to the most elevated norms of the universal morality, and incompatible with the more simple requirements of an international peaceful coexistence. It then was when we were profoundly moved by the attitude of the Mexican government and people. We then proposed to ourselves to one day come to our native land so that with our presence make known of the sentiments of love towards all, the I, them. Just as to the imperishable friendship that since then and forevermore unites our peoples. Mr. President, the eloquent words which I have just pronounced are deeply felt, however, does not constitute the first of the pleasant emotions of which we have experimented on since our arrival to Mexico, nor, we are sure, will it be the last. The manifestations of sympathy with which we have been received are because of its spontaneity, undoubted testimony, and furthermore expression of the currents of affection and comprehension that exist between both nations, determined in some things by the similarities and in others by the identity of emotions and even the topography of the two countries. You had said, Mr. President, how you wished for our stay in our country would be to us both pleasant and agreeable, and to that I must now answer that such cordial and sincere wishes now a reality fully attained. What we have seen up until today, and that of your admiral country, of its institutions, of its customs, and of the feelings of its inhabitants, we know by various and trustworthy conducts, demonstrate the love and sympathy that is felt for Ethiopia. In all and without reservations, we share in the hope that has been manifested, in that our direct knowledge contributes to the edification of a widening of relations that exist among our nations. National Palace, June 21st, 1954, Emperor Haile Selassie I.